What's the difference between a smartwatch and a fitness tracker? A fitness tracker is designed to keep track of your health and exercise. A smartwatch keeps the track of your fitness too, but it also keeps you connected by delivering notifications and updates on your wrist. There's a lot of overlap between the two. A Massfit Bip S Lite might be the best budget option available. Welcome back. This is Adam from Family Pop TV. Stay with me to find out more. Amazfit. This brand is particularly good at building impressive longevity into its products, something that a lot of the bigger rivals fail to deliver on. The Bip S Lite is no exception. Claiming an impressive 45-day battery life, this compact budget fitness tracker is the follow-up to the Amazfit Bip and has nearly all the same specs except GPS tracking. When I took it out of the box, I was positively surprised by the design and the quality of the silicone strap. The box contains the Bip S Lite itself, a magnetic charging cable, and the multilingual instruction manuals. The watch case is made of plastic and has a PPG bio-tracking optical sensor for heart rate monitoring. There are the magnetic charging pins, and there's one multifunctional button on the side of the watch. The rectangular shape and lightweight materials gives the watch quite a sporty look. You can choose between three colors of Bip S Lite: charcoal black, Oxford blue, and Sakura pink. The watch weighs only 31 grams, making it light and unobtrusive wearable. I honestly forgot that I was wearing it sometimes. It's comfortable and easy to put on, and isn't too bulky around your wrist either. Amazfit Bip S Lite is waterproof to 5 ATM, which means it's water resistant up to 15 meters, and we found this to work well. You can wear it while you're swimming, however, it can't actually track swimming as a specific activity, only your heart rate during the exercise. We made a waterproof test just to be absolutely sure before taking it to the pool. To recap, the ATM5 enclosure means it will withstand the pressure up to 5 bars, or can be used on depths up to 50 meters or 165 feet, and we found this to work well. Because the construction of the watch is all plastic, you can't even get it to the salty water, where most of the watches won't end well while submerged into conductive water. Bip S Lite will survive the sea and the ocean challenge. I'll quickly show you the most important features of Bip S Lite. The step counter is well accurate. It gives you an estimation of your steps, but it's very accurate. I have done exactly 1000 steps with a manual tally counter in my hand. And the Bip S Lite has counted 1002 steps. That's unbelievable. This clearly gives you a decent 99.8% of accuracy. That's amazing. I like the graphical representation of the heart rate range. The Bip S Lite accuracy in monitoring the heart rate is decent. We have compared the heart rate readings from the watch with a medical pulse oximeter, which provides very accurate heart rate measurements. Okay, let's start the first measurement. I'm resting now, and the heart rate readings show 76 BPM on both devices. Great, let's take another go. Now I'm relaxed. 69 BPM on both devices. That's fantastic. Okay, let's take it to the higher level. I'll do the next two heart rate measurements during the workout. Obviously, these readings should be used for reference only. However, these are well accurate. The Bip S Lite shows 100 BPM, the oximeter 99 BPM. This is still 99% of accuracy. Fantastic. Let's do it again. The BPM dropped a little bit. It's 94 BPM on both devices. As you can see, the Bip S Lite performs very well. The heart rate tracking is outstanding as for a non-medical device. The readings are nearly identical in both devices. The 1.28 inches display area is protected with Gorilla Glass 3 with its native damage resistance, so the glass can survive pressures, deep cuts, and scratches. It's got 176 by 176 pixel screen, but as soon as I turned the watch on, the display wasn't exactly impressive. I wasn't impressed for two reasons. It's got a large bezels, which kind of spoil the look. And its always-on transflective TFT screen is kind of dull and lack of vivid colors and brightness comparing to IPS or AMOLED screens spoiled the excitement a little bit. Don't get me wrong, the screen is basic but designed to be easy to read and navigate. It gets the job done and it's easy to look at mid-workout and it's perfectly readable under almost any ambient light conditions. By the way, the transflective display technology isn't new. It has been used for the first time in 2013 in legendary Pebble smartwatch. It is very energy efficient, making it ideal for long-lasting smartwatches. The display has 5 levels of brightness. I would recommend the maximum level. It's bright enough even in a sunny day, and thanks to its transflectivity, it doesn't drain its 200 mAh battery, which can last up to 45 days on a single charge when the watch isn't constantly connected to the phone or in a standby mode. The proprietary charging cradle can charge the Bip S Lite from drained to full in less than 2 hours. Out of curiosity, I have checked what users of Bip S Lite saying about this watch. There are very positive reviews on Amazon, a super lightweight watch, or solid, basic and reliable option. Another one, loads of technology for a low price. Here's the Spanish one, which means great for this price. There's a 4-star one. Good watch, allergic to the band. Well, no worries, the band can be replaced for any 20mm wristband. It can be leather, breathable canvas, metal or some super soft silicone strap, as long as these straps are 20mm wide. I'll show you on how to quickly replace the straps. Pull this little pin here and then you pull the strap away from the watch. And to put it back or replace it with a new strap, you just have to reverse the steps. Pull the pin, pull the strap away from the watch. Pull the pin, it clicked, and you're good to go. Simple and straightforward. The Bip S Lite uses Zepp companion app that you install on your phone. Once paired with the watch, it sets up the time and controls most of the watch functionality. You'll have to scan a QR code with your smartphone to get to the Apple Store on Google Play, as the app is compatible with both iOS and Android. The QR code can be found in the included manual. Here in the app, you'll get a detailed graph of your activities, set the alarms, set your goals, notifications, etc. and it will give you control on everything the Bip S Lite has to offer. Bip S Lite has 14 workout modes: outdoor running, treadmill, cycling, indoor cycling, freestyle, which means weight exercises, walking, elliptical trainer, yoga, jump rope, badminton, ping pong, cricket, basketball and rowing machine. You can easily keep track of these exercises in real time directly on the watch, and it allows you to understand your physical condition. Unfortunately, Bip S Lite hasn't got a GPS on board, so you can't track your position during workouts unless you would start the workout from the companion app. Bip S Lite hasn't got GPS, but its more expensive version, Amazfit Bip S, has built-in GPS, but obviously it comes at the cost of shorter battery life. Bip S Lite also gets PAI, which stands for Personal Activity Intelligence, and is used to set fitness goals over a period of time rather than having goals for every single day. It pushes the weather info from your phone. To use this feature, the watch has to be connected with your phone. It pushes the notifications about incoming text messages and social apps messages, as well as notifications about an incoming calls. You can't pick an upcoming call, you could only drop it. And it will only work when your watch is connected with your smartphone via Bluetooth. Sleep tracking on Bip S Lite is mostly accurate and is broken into 3 phases: deep sleep, light sleep and awake. All the data is presented in a graphical form, and you also get a sleep score and a few suggestions from Amazfit Sleep Assistant to improve the quality of your sleep. However, it struggles to measure nap or sleep during the day, but it works fine when I sleep during the night. Bip S Lite hasn't got much of a customization, as you'd be only able to download the watch faces from the selection of around 60 of them via the companion app. Some of these watch faces are a reminiscence of a retro electronic watches. I personally like it, and the sync of the watch faces is almost instant. By press and hold the display, you can quickly switch between the watch faces stored in your watch. There are other useful features which requires Bluetooth connection with your phone, and there are Find Phone. To make sure this feature works, Bip S Lite has to be connected with your phone via Bluetooth, and the Zep Companion app has to run in the background. Same for the Music Player Control, where you can control your music app in your smartphone once the devices are connected. Just be aware, Bip S Lite won't trigger the music player when you press the display. You'll have to manually switch the music app on your phone first. Once that's done, you'll be able to switch between songs and turn up or down the volume. To say it as honestly as possible, this is a good budget entry-level smartwatch. Bip S Lite is available worldwide on Amazon. You can get it on Amazon UK from £29 to £49, depends on the color. Amazon US for around $49. Amazon Deutschland for around 31 euro. Amazon France for about 33 euros. Amazon Italy from 35 euro. Amazon Spain from 33 euros. And Amazon Poland from around 190 zlotych. If you're thinking about buying this one, there's an Amazon link in the video description where you could find it for the fair price. Guys, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed today's video and found it pretty informative. Please show us some love, and if you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing to Family Pop TV.